Glory to God. Let us all make a joyful noise unto the Lord.
Alleluia.
Let us all just worship him this morning. Let us give him the glory and the honor that is due to him this morning. Rejoice in the Lord this morning, for the joy of the Lord is our strength this morning. Father God, we thank you that we can be here in your presence, oh God. We thank you, oh God, that we can be here, oh Lord. We give you the glory and the honor, oh God, for every praise belongs to you this morning, oh God. We surrender all to you this morning, oh God. We pray, oh Father God, in the name of Jesus, that you just have your way this morning, oh God. Saturate us this morning, oh Lord. We welcome you in this place this morning, oh Lord. Would you come, oh Father? Send your spirit, oh Lord, and saturate us this morning, oh Lord. We want more of you this morning, oh Lord. We hunger, we thirst for you this morning, oh Lord. Would you satisfy us this morning, oh Lord? Would you come, Holy Spirit? Sweet Spirit, we pray. Just come and fill this place this morning, oh Lord. Fill every home this morning, oh Lord. Fill every family this morning, oh Lord. Just have your way with us this morning, oh Lord. Breakthrough, oh Father, like only you can do, oh Lord. Breakthrough so that we can worship you this morning, oh Lord. Breakthrough, oh Father God. We surrender to you this morning, oh Lord. Unto Jesus we surrender all this morning, oh Lord. May you have the glory and the honor this morning, O Lord. We rejoice in you this morning, O Lord. You are worthy, O Lord. Shararabayenda rabasuto rabayenda rabashondo. Shararabayenda rabasuto rabayenda rabashondo. Shararabayenda rabasuto rabayenda rabashondo. We give you the glory, O God. You are great and greatly to be praised this morning, O Lord. You are worthy, O Lord. We thank you for the cross this morning, oh Lord. We thank you for the nail-pierced hands, oh Lord. We thank you for the precious blood of Jesus. We cover each and every one of us under that blood this morning. We cover every home under the blood of Jesus this morning. We cover every family under the blood of Jesus this morning. Oh yes, Lord. You just have your way this morning, oh Lord. You go before us, oh Lord. You shield our way this morning, oh Lord. You are great and greatly to be praised, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Shararabayanda rabasuto rabayanda rabashondoi. Shararabayanda rabasuto rabayanda rabashondoi. Oh, glory to you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You are our Savior, Lord. Let us worship him this morning. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Just praise him this morning. Worship him this morning. Give him your all this morning. For he is your Savior. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Atoning sacrifice. Keeper of this life, hallelujah, you are Savior. Beginning and the end, forgiver of my sin. By your mercy, you have saved us. Order!
Thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Father, for your mercy. We thank you this morning as we gather here. Oh, God, to give you praise and worship, oh, God. Lead us, oh, God, oh, God. You are a living hope this morning. You are a living hope, oh, God. Oh, you, you died on the cross for us, and you rose and died. Oh, God, we give you praise and we give you thanks this morning. Hallelujah. Glory in the name of
Jesus.
Oh God, you are our living hope this morning. Lord, we are praising you. And we are giving you praise, oh God. Stir up everything, oh God. We give you, we confess our sin to you, oh God. We come short to the glory of God. Lord, you died on the cross for our sin and you paid the price for our sin. Oh yes, Lord. Oh God, forgive us our sins this morning as we forgive those who sin against us this morning. Oh God, as you continue to be our living hope, oh God. And we are going to praise you this morning. We're going to worship you, God. We're going to worship you in praise and spirit and truth this morning. We're going to give you all the glory and all the honor this morning. And we thank you, and as we lift your name on high, oh God, we're going to be continue to be your living hope. We are going to continue to be a living hope. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Glory to God.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory be to God.
How great a chasm that lay between us. How high the mountain I could not climb. In desperation I turned to heaven and spoke your name into the night. Then through the darkness, your loving kindness tore through the shadows of my soul. The work is finished, the end is written, Jesus Christ, my living hope. Who could so great a mercy, what heart could fathom such boundless grace? The God of ages stepped down from glory to wear my sin and bear my shame. The cross has spoken, I am forgiven. Calls me his own. Beautiful Savior, I'm yours forever. Jesus Christ, my living hope. Hallelujah, praise the Lord. your buried body began to breathe. Out of the silence, the roaring lion declares the grave has no claim on me. Then came the morning that sealed a promise. Your buried body began to breathe. Out of the silence, the roaring lion declares the grave has no claim on me. Jesus, yours is the God, we believe no matter what, there is power in your name. So much power in your name. Move the immovable, break the unbreakable. God, we believe. God, we believe for it. From the impossible, we'll see a miracle. God, we believe. God, we believe for it. Move the immovable, break the unbreakable. God, we believe. Yes, we believe for it. From the impossible, we'll see a miracle. God, we believe. God, we believe for it. God, we believe. God, we believe for it. God, we believe. God, we believe for it. You are the way where there seems to be no way. I trust in you, cause you have the final say. You are the way where there seems to be no way. I trust in you, cause you have the final say. You are the way where there seems to be no way. I trust in you, cause you have the final say. Move the immovable, break the unbreakable. God, we believe. God, we believe for it. From the impossible, we'll see a miracle. God, we believe. God, we believe for it. Move the immovable, break the unbreakable. God, we believe. God, we believe for it. From the impossible, we'll see a miracle. God, we believe. God, we believe for it. God, we believe. God, we believe for it. God, we believe. God, we believe for it. Hallelujah. You are the way, O Lord, where there seems to be no way, O Lord. You have the final say, O Lord, and we believe for it, O God. You will break the unbreakable, O Lord. You will move the impossible, O Lord, out of every situation, O Lord. We will see a miracle, O Lord. We thank you, O Lord, for making a way for us, O Lord. We thank you, O Lord, because you are a way maker, O Lord. You are a promise keeper, O Lord. You are the light in the darkness, O Lord. And we believe in you, O Lord. We believe in you, Jesus. We believe in you, Father. Hallelujah. We give you the glory, O Lord. We will see you do it again, O Lord. Every mountain will come down in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God.
We thank you for your faithfulness, O Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Walking around these walls, I thought by now they'd fall, but you haven't failed me yet. Waiting for change to come, knowing the battle's won, for you haven't failed me yet. You Your promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness, your faithfulness. I'm still in your hands, and this is my confidence. You never fail me yet. You never fail me yet. Your word will come to pass. My heart will sing your praise again. Jesus, you're still enough. Keep me within your love. My heart will sing your praise again. Your promise stands. Great is your faithfulness, your faithfulness. I'm still in your hands, and this is my confidence. You never fail. Promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness, your faithfulness. I'm still in your hands, and this is my confidence. You never fail me yet. You never fail me yet.
Your heart.
thank you, O Lord, for you never failed us, O Lord. You come chasing after us, O Lord. We thank you for that love, O Lord. We thank you for your faithfulness, O Lord. We thank you for your goodness, O God. We give you the praise, O Lord. We give you the honor, O Lord. We give you thanks this morning, O Lord. We give you the glory this morning, O Lord. You are worthy, O God. We thank you this morning, O Lord. Every praise belongs to you this morning, O Lord. We give you the glory, O God. We give you the honor this morning, O Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. At this time, I turn you over to Sister Lynn.
Well, praise the Lord. We want to welcome all of you, those of you here and those of you watching online. I want you to know that the Lord is good. God is good.
Amen.
All the time and all the time, God is good. I guess you could praise the Lord today because you opened your eyes today.
Amen.
So that means you are alive and you're well. If you're not sick, you don't have too much things going on in your life, you need to thank God for that. And doing that, you need to give God praise and thanks. If you could make it out to church, it would be best for you to, you know, fellowship together, because the Bible says, let us not forsake the assembling together. And as long as you could make that decision and that desire within your heart, it has to come from within your heart. If it doesn't come from within your heart, that means, you know, you got to pray against whatever is trying to keep you away from church and keep you away from, because there's a loosening up right now. So there's no need for you to get panic or fearful, because God hasn't given us a spirit of fear, but of love, of power, and of a sound mind.
Amen.
So today, as we worship the Lord, just think about these things and allow God to work in your life today. Praise the Lord. Just for a few announcements, I want you to remember that there's some change with our prayer meeting. Our prayer meeting will be on Tuesday on Zoom at 7:30. So I want you to remember that. If you want to join in, just text us or email us and we will send a link so that you could join us. And our Bible study is on Wednesday, and the time has changed to 7:30. So Bible study on Wednesday, 7:30, and that will be on Facebook. So I want you to remember those two changes, and we'll be back here again next Sunday for a worship service. So I want you to pray and trust the Lord and keep holding on to the Lord. Hallelujah. So now I'm going to read a scripture verse. The scriptures for today, it's on Romans chapter 7. For I know that in me, that is, in my flesh, dwelleth no good thing. For the will is present with me, but how to perform that which is good, I find not. For I know that nothing good dwells within me, in my flesh. I can will what is right, but I cannot perform it. I have the intention and urge to do what is right, but no power to carry it out.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. So I want you to remember that. And now I turn you over to my husband, Pastor David Jawa, here for the word of God. Praise the Lord.
Okay. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. It's so good to see all of you in service today. I want you to know that the Lord is doing something great and something wonderful. Hallelujah. The presence of the Lord is in this place. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And the joy of the Lord is in your heart. Isn't that so?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. It's so good to see your presence. Your presence make a difference in my life, in somebody else's life, and in God's divine will. Your presence is very important. Now, Today I'd like to begin, I won't say a series, might be a couple of messages. So I'm speaking on overcoming the flesh. Overcoming the flesh. And there's a very interesting verse and popular verse in the book of Galatians, chapter 5, verse 16. This I know then, walk in the Spirit, and ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. Walk in the Spirit, and ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. I want to welcome at this time all the Facebook listeners and everybody, you who have been following us. You have been a great inspiration to our being here. I'm here and the others are here because of the Lord. The Lord is doing something great in our life. And we would like to share the testimony. We would like to share what God is doing in our heart. This message today is an important message for every one of us. We have got something very hard to overcome. Something very difficult in our life, in our way. And that is the flesh. The flesh has not been an easy thing for us. The Pope got problem with his flesh. He might seem to be infallible, but he is a man. Amen? And he got problem with his flesh. The greatest pastor, the greatest evangelist, the greatest apostle have problem with his flesh. The man who wrote this was a Christian over 36 years. He said, for I know that in me, that is in my flesh, dwelleth no good thing. To will is present for me, but to perform it, but to perform what I will, that which is good, I find it not. He's saying, I want to do good, but I can't do good. There's a problem there. There's something that's holding me back from doing good. Isn't that the way you are many times? Up to yesterday or up to today, you want to live the Christian life, but you come to a full stop. You want to live a life without sin, but you come to a full stop. And you're having a problem. I'm having that problem. And this man who wrote this in the Bible, his name is the Apostle Paul. And for over 36 years, he found this problem always there. Always there. And if Paul, who wrote over half of the New Testament, could get this problem, why not me or you? Are you having this problem today? Have you gotten a problem to overcome the flesh? Have you got a problem with your temper? Have you got a problem with eating? Well, think about it. The Apostle Paul had a problem. Let's pray. Father, Lord, in Jesus' name, we pray that your Spirit going to move now, God. And take over. We thank you for you moving our worship. You bless us. I thank you for those who are viewing and those who are listening. You have ministered and you will continue to minister, O God. You know how many of us are having problems. And we all have problems. But you are great. You came in this world and you live without any sin. You live without sin. You became sin so that we could be delivered from sin. Hallelujah. 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 I praise your God because even now you will help us. Because you're God. And because we serve you, minister to us, O God, through your word, and help us to overcome what is hindering us. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Glory to God. You know, sometimes we say it's hard to go on. Sometimes we say we give up. Isn't that it, sir? Because it seems like we have reached a tragedy in our life. And it does not mean anything to me now that I should go on. Sometimes you say, it's best I die. You ever feel like that? So many times, years ago, I prayed that prayer. Lord, take me as I am. But the Lord didn't see it fit at that time. Neither now. Even lately, I could have said, Lord, I give up. But no. There might be some pain in the flesh. But those spend some time, they are good. And they will help you to go on. They will help you to be a conqueror. They will help you to be more than a conqueror. Hallelujah. And Paul was in the feet, as I said, for over 36 years. When he wrote that verse, I want to do something good. But every time I find myself wanting to do good, there's something that is hindering me. I want to serve the Lord. I want to pray today. I want to fast. I want more of Jesus. But something come in the way that blocked me. To dwell in the flesh is giving Satan the biggest advantage in your life. Stop looking at the things that hinder you. And the things that block you from moving forward in your Christian life. Stop looking at the hurdles, how high they are. And stop complaining and know that Jesus is able to help you. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So to give Satan that advantage over you is telling him, I want you to control my life. But to look beyond that and to look at Jesus, who faced all the problems, all the temptation of this life, and yet, he stood up tall and he conquered everything. He overcome every problem that face him. We can say, indeed, he's more than a conqueror. He's more than a conqueror. Hallelujah. And since he's more than a conqueror, why I should not be one? Now, this thing you call the flesh is one of the greatest weapons that Satan has used over mankind or over us. And you know what they're talking about. I come to it just now. There are problems that we have in our life, and they are there because we allow the flesh to take over. We allow the flesh to take over. And Satan uses the weakness of the flesh to bring confusion and draw out our weaknesses and put it before people. And people say, oh, look at you, look at he, oh, that is brother so-and-so. And he fall in big, big problem. You know, sometimes we want to condemn people and we are just the same. We got the same problem. We carry the same load. We got the same flesh problem. The Bible says in the flesh dwells no good thing. I mean this flesh, but the nature. See, everybody says the nature. The nature. Hallelujah. The flesh is defined as a nature of living. So it is not this thing that cover up your bones and cover up your what's a nature of living, thinking and acting against the ways or the will of God. So when you fighting a problem to do good, you're living, you're thinking, you're acting, come into being and rebel against the will and the ways of God. How many of you are like that? Nobody. Oh, yeah, me. I'm like that. You see, and you know, and you know God tell you to do something, and you still are having a problem to do it. Isn't that so, sister? Isn't that so, Brother Shook? Yes, I got that problem. And sometimes, 1, 2, 3 attempts I make and I fail. But God is good and make us more than conqueror. The Bible says, this is the victory that overcometh the world, even our feet. And so when we put our faith in Jesus, when we put our faith in his word, we are able to overcome these problems. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. To dwell in the realm of the flesh is to allow Satan to have an advantage over your life, or to take control of your desires. In so doing, you are submitting yourself to defeat. Don't submit yourself to defeat. Stop looking at that. Defeat is not your name. More than a conqueror is your name. Victorious is your name. Jesus Christ is part of you, is you. He's more than a conqueror. He's victorious. And so here I continue to define the word. Define the word fresh. It means to indulge in sensual appetite and to live in sin. Is there something that's sensual? Something that draw, entice you away from God? Walking with desires that seek to fulfill the lust of the flesh, being controlled by urges that are strongholds. Here I come to a part that we all need to, I will not preach on it or teach on it today, but maybe next week or the other week, we're going to come to strongholds. Strongholds are grips of the flesh that Satan has put in your life. Strongholds, the name of the word tell you much. It is not a weak hold, but a stronghold. It's hard to get rid of this thing. It's hard to pull it out of your life. It's hard to put it away from you. It is a stronghold because it has been there, friends, since your childhood days. It is built up there. Being built up in the mind that exists layers upon layers. You know, you ever see things get buried? Have you ever looked at these documentaries of them lifting up a city or a building or a place from the earth? They have to go so many feet down, and when they uncover it, when they uncover the dirt, they uncover everything, they uncover the building. Why? Because after years upon years, things built up. And so in our lives, after years upon years of sinning and doing wrong things, there are things that can come back again. And they make strong. So to get rid of these things, you got to peel out layer upon layer upon layer. It's like peeling an onion. You get the first layer, you get the next layer, you get the next layer, and so you see the inner core being revealed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When one lives like this, it affects the mind, the life, the body, your soul. The flesh or the old man, we always call the flesh the old man. Somebody say, you need to get rid of the old man, so you go home and you put out the old man. No, not that old man that you need to put. There's an old man in you that you need to get rid of. the unregenerated man, the unregenerated, there are things that are in you that are not regenerated. You say you are Christian. Yes, but that does not make you a perfect person. You live as a Christian is an overcoming life. It is a life daily that you have to live. And you have to face crucifixion daily as you live this life. It's a way of living. Hallelujah. So, I'm going to come to the point where we're going to look at the twofold aspect of the flesh. Twofold aspect or twofold dimension of the flesh. The first dimension has to do mainly of the nature of sin. The nature of sin within us. Second has to do with strongholds within us. You know you face problem in prayer, isn't that so? We all face problem in prayer. And sometimes we pray for things long time and it seems like if we not get an answer. But there is a stronghold that we need to get rid of. But we're not going to speak about that today. The first dimension in the sin nature of man is not regeneration. No matter how innocent you are. I'll read that again. The first dimension is the sin nature of man. That is not regenerated, no matter how innocent you are. So, a sin nature within us, a nature that is not regenerated, or we could say saved, or not fully developed to be like Christ. All of us face problems with this. We find a nature, a way of life within us that cannot go beyond what I am. And so I struggle many times with this nature. I struggle with it daily over and over. And so I realize that in sin did my mother conceive me. And within me is the very nature of the fallen man. I have within me what you call the Adamic nature. The Adamic nature is within me and live within me. And it's unregenerated. I become a Christian. I'm a pastor. I'm a teacher of the word. But I realize that deep within me, there are things that are not wanted as a Christian in my life. So what would I do? Would I give up living for Jesus? No. I have to conquer. I have to move on. I have to grow. I have to develop each day. And no matter how somebody look, they all face this problem. The biggest of preacher, the biggest of a minister has this problem. And it's living in them. It's deep-seated within them. You see all the glory of them. You see with them ministering. And you say, I wish I could be like that man. But you don't know that sometime when that man finished ministering, he's living in sin. He's living in wickedness. So how do we overcome this nature? The remedy for that is what we call deliverance. And it is in the same thing that you say that you have, salvation. I told you before, your spirit is 100% saved. There's no fault what God has done within you. For the good work that he has done within you is a work that Jesus Christ has accomplished at the cross, at his resurrection, at his ascension, and sitting at the right hand of God. There's no fault in that. And you have the power of the resurrection within you, but it's within your spirit. So you could see that your spirit man is regenerated, is saved. But when come to the soul, what happened? It's not 100%. The soul goes through struggles. And at times there are many faults in the soul. And so there's a problem with my soul, with your soul. What will you do then? As I say, the remedy is in your salvation. Your remedy is in your salvation. The most important work is done within you as a child of God. You have salvation. You have perfectness within your spirit. But the soul struggle. The body, struggle even more. You cannot correct this, the problem that you are having by yourself. It takes the substitutionary work of Jesus Christ for this to be corrected. And takes faith. It takes yielding. Say yielding to the Word of God. Yielding to the Holy Spirit. Yielding to what God has done. It takes your faith in God to get these things corrected. You by yourself, I by myself, cannot correct it. It's more than that. I already covered that. What to do with the flesh? What to do with the flesh? I come for us with the cross, with the blood of Jesus. With the cross. Say the cross, the blood of Jesus. You have problem, I have problem. What do we do? What do we do with this thing called flesh? Only through the blood. Whosoever has the Son has eternal life. You're born again. But the question is, am I submitted to God? You are born again. You are Christian. You are saved. But are you submitted to the word of God? Are you submitted to the work that he has done? Are you submitted to your Savior? Is he really Lord of your soul, of Lord of your body? That is a question that we all have to ask ourselves. What do I do with the flesh? How do I overcome it? How do I overcome certain things that is going on in my life? The Apostle Paul said, I am crucified with Christ. Have you ever crucified anything? Well, we need to do one crucifixion. Crucify our self to Christ. And crucify with Christ. That is all that he has gone through at the cross. I can identify myself with him. I can identify myself with him going through those things. The only thing is that I am not nailed to the cross. But when he was nailed there, I was with him. I'm crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live, yet not I. So when it comes to living this life, you have to realize it's not David anymore. It's not Indra anymore. It's not Becky anymore. It's Jesus within me. And it's no more I that liveth, but Christ liveth in me. Christ is allowed to have his life within me. So I'm yielding. Say yielding. I'm yielding myself. I'm yielding my life to him. I'm giving over my life to him. You have done well. You have accepted Christ as your Savior, but now you are giving over your life to him. It's no more I, but him. It's him. How many of us who are Christians can really say, it's not me, but Christ? You're going to know when you leave this church today, it's no more us, but Christ. Somebody bother you, you won't say, bless you, brother. That was good. I love you. Most likely, the reaction with somebody who bother you is to get angry, get vexed. When you become angry, what works up is the flesh. But when you learn to bless somebody, love somebody, in the midst of your tribulation, when you learn to say, hello, I love you, in the midst of your tribulation, you are portraying not your attitude, but a Christ-like attitude. You are portraying something that is within you, and you are giving place to a greater, greater something than you. You push aside anger. You push aside clamor. You push aside all the vexation. You push aside all the dirty words. And Christ surface itself in the new. And the life which I now live in the flesh. In the what? In the flesh. I live by the faith of the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me. So I yield myself and allow him to come out. To come out, to express himself in me. I yield myself to him and allow him to express himself in me. Hallelujah. Galatians 5:16-18. This I say then, walk in the Spirit. So the first thing you do to conquer flesh, you crucify yourself. You go to the cross. Now I come to the Spirit. Allowing the Holy Spirit to live within you. And to be a dynamic force within you, allowing him to be a holy one within you. This I say then, walk in the Spirit. Walk in the Spirit, and ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. Temptations will come. That Jesus faced as a man, not as God, but a man, he faced temptations. The devil tempted him and said, if you be the Son of God, turn this bread into, turn this stone into bread. He did not bother with the devil. He did not, he know he was the Son of God. He got to do something to prove that. You know that you're a child of God. You don't have to do something to prove that. You need to walk in the Spirit. Now note that when Jesus Christ was tempted in the wilderness, was after he had the experience of the Holy Ghost coming upon him and filling him and possessing him. And he was filled of the Holy Ghost. And he walked into the wilderness to be tempted of the devil. You say he walked in there to fight. He walked in there to be tempted. He bring himself to that place because he know that he had to conquer Satan. He had to conquer this devil that's coming various ways to get at him. And let me tell you something. You are walking out of this church today. You're walking home. You're going to go home. You're going to drive or whatsoever. But you will face temptations. But don't allow yourself to be carried away with the, by the tempter. Instead, you stand up and you live in the Spirit. You allow the Holy Spirit to live through you. You allow the Holy Spirit to give you the power. You allow the Holy Spirit to help you to overcome the tempter. Say, Holy Spirit, come and help me. This I say then, walk in the Spirit, and you shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. For the flesh lusteth against the Spirit, and the Spirit against the flesh. There's a war. See, there's a war. There's a war that's going on within you. There's a war. That war is a spirit and the flesh. And you know what I mean. The flesh wars against the spirit daily. The flesh war against you to do something that is wrong daily. The flesh bring thoughts to you, bring imaginations to you. And I'm going to get into that. He bring these thoughts, he bring these imaginations and bombard you with all sorts of things. Enticement. He fight. The flesh fight against the spirit. These are contrary one to another, so that you cannot do the things that you would. But if you be led of the Spirit, you are not under the law. If you be led, say led. If I am led by the Holy Spirit, I would not yield to what the devil is saying. I would not yield to what the devil wants me to do. The devil is using my flesh, is using that nature within me to live his life. Christ used the Spirit of God to manifest himself through you into this world. I repeat that. Christ uses his spirit in you to manifest himself through your spirit. And when you're led by the spirit, you will not fulfill the lust of the flesh. When you walk by the spirit, you will not fulfill what the devil wants you to do. So today, we look at the crucified life. I'm crucified with Christ. The cross, the blood of Jesus, with that he conquered Satan. With his resurrection, he overcome the enemy. And now we look at the Spirit of God given to us so that we can overcome the things that are contrary to the ways of God. I'm going to close here now. I'm going to continue this message. So I want you to note two things, especially the cross and the spirit. With the power of his blood, with the power of his resurrection, with his power that is accomplished through the finished work. What is it? The finished work. You have given a perfect salvation, a perfect life through the cross. And through the Spirit, you are given a life of power, a life that's dynamic, a life that's fruitful through the Holy Ghost. So today, if you would spend some time and yield to those two truths of the cross and the Holy Spirit, we can be victorious. We can be victorious. Remember, the flesh is a nature within every one of us. It's a deadly nature. It's a deadly something. It's a nature of living, thinking, and acting against the will or the ways of God. And you don't want to be that person that go against the ways or the will of God for your life. You don't want to be that person that's carried away by every form of doctrine or what people say. Oh, no. Or carried away by your own enticement. You don't want the devil to use you. You don't want that. You are an overcomer through the cross and through the Holy Spirit. Through the cross and through the Holy Spirit. Remember, our flesh is one of the greatest weapons that Satan uses to overcome us, to get us discouraged, to get us down. And we feel as if somebody hurt me. Somebody has taken advantage over me. But we have not learned Jesus to turn the other cheek. We have not learned Jesus when people get at us. It is an opportunity for us to be a conqueror. When people get at you, it is an opportunity, for you to be victorious. So I'm not going to allow myself to live in my past, to allow myself to think of what people say, to allow myself to what? To those things they keep me down because they came from losers. Not champions. Champion is Jesus. He has made me victorious. Hallelujah. Remember, it's a tragedy to live in the flesh. Remember, all of us got this problem. And so, in these few messages, I'm going to teach on overcoming the flesh. This I say then, walk in the Spirit, and you shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. Let's pray. Hallelujah. 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 Shalababa. Let's pray. Spend some time. Talk to the Lord. Shalababa. I don't know you, but the Lord sees you, and the Lord sees what is going on. You might be looking at me right now through Facebook, YouTube. You might be looking, then this message is for you. God has got this word stored up for you today so that you can be an overcomer. Shalababa. And so right now, I bring and I lift up all the people that are listening to you, my God. Here and over the line on Facebook and YouTube, I bring them before you in the name of Jesus. I pray that your spirit would wipe and would clear off the darkness that is over the mind, that is over the veil of flesh. The veil of flesh will be removed, and the Holy Spirit will penetrate every barrier, every evil, every wickedness, every work of Satan, every work of the flesh. You're going to penetrate right now and minister. I lift up that person that needs help, the cry to you, the struggle with the ex-husband, struggle with family problems, struggle living the Christian life, struggling and be victorious, struggling with relationships, struggling. God, I pray that your power, the power of your spirit, the power of your cross, the power of the blood of Jesus be released now into these lives, into homes, into families that need the touch right now. Shalababa. 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 Shalaba. Shalaba. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Spend some time. Don't go away just like that. The Lord wants to minister to you. He wants you to be an overcomer. For too long, we carry the problem. Too long, we carry our shame. We give that to Christ and allow the Spirit of God to come alive in this situation now. Shalababa. 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 Glory to God. Glory to God. Yes, Lord, minister, minister now. Touch that heart, touch that soul, minister, in Jesus' name. Let the power of the Holy Ghost fall upon me. Let the power of the Holy Ghost fall upon me. Let the power of the Holy Ghost fall upon me. Anointing roll on me,
anointing roll on me. Let the power of the Holy Ghost fall on me, anointing fall on me.
Sing it again, anointing. Anointing rise in me.
Anointing rise in me. Anointing rise in me. Let the power of
shall again one more time anoint to rise. Anointing rise in me now. Anointing rise within your people now. Destroy that yoke, that problem, that evil spirit, that familiar spirit has been following us. Shalababa. Destroy the wicked spirits that seek to curse. Destroy it in Jesus' name. Anointing, anointing, destroy. Give me the victory, O God. Give us the victory today. Lead us into green pasture and beside the still water, let the Holy Ghost flow over our soul, flow over the flesh man, flow over the soul. Let the Spirit of God from our spirit flow into our soul, flow into the flesh, flow into the desires, flow into the nature of us. Flow, Holy Spirit, flow. Let holiness be part of us. Be us in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Lord, we praise you for the miracle today. The miracle that you have started and you have finished and you have accomplished. I thank you for the miracle, that the power of the Holy Spirit, the power of the anointing that destroys every yoke. I pray for our loved ones, oh God, those who are going through deep problems in the flesh. God, bless them. Bless our loved ones. Bless those that we know. Bless those. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Shalababa yendalababa yendalaba. There's somebody watching and you need a miracle. And you need a miracle for someone too. There's a cry. Shalababa. Oh God, you're able to deliver us. And no matter how deep a problem might look on the surface, I want you to know that Jesus Christ has made us more than conquerors. Shalaba. And no matter how hard it might look, you are a champion. You are a champion. Shalababa. Shalababa. And let the Spirit of God surface within you. Shalababa. In Jesus' name. Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. You may look up. I'm so glad that you could have been in service today. I'm so glad to have you. You know, ministering here, for me, it takes courage. And for me, it might look hard at times. But I have come to realize that I can do all things through Christ, who strengthens me. And my life is not my own. My life is God's. And so is you. So is all of us. When we yield to Him, we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. Today, I want you to go home, enjoy yourself with your family, and live for Jesus. Live big for Jesus. If you have an offering or something to give unto the Lord, Aileen, you can take up the offering now and you can give unto the Lord. And remember, on Tuesday is our prayer meeting. I want more of you to join us on Zoom. I send out the invitation to lots of people. You just have to click on the link and it will help you to get to us. And we pray together. This week is the first week we will be doing our prayer meeting separate from the time of when we end and we do the Bible study. So we will have more time praying and more time in discussion. So I put at least 1 hour into praying, discussion, and talking. And after that hour, if you want to spend some time with me and make me feel joyful, you're welcome. Welcome to do it too. Right? So we can continue that discussion on Tuesday. Remember, on Wednesday, we continue in the book of Revelation. We finish 2 churches, Ephesus and Smyrna. We will go on. We will either do 1 or 2 churches this week. So I see you in Bible study on Wednesday and Tuesday on the prayer meeting, and then back next week at 10 o'clock here for the worship service. God bless you. Very good. Amen.